manager is there. So the two basic functions are there for memory manager. One is allocation, another is deallocation, right? So most of the time we study about allocation of the memory. Deallocation, you know, a little bit we study. Reason is that you know, most of the programming languages are having this deallocation part inbuilt, and we don't have much to do with them for, you know, developing new programs. Okay, so properties of memory managers, like, you know, space efficiency, program efficiency, and low overhead. So these are the reason why we need the memory manager. Okay, so typical memory hierarchy configurations, if you see in a program, we have registers, then we have first level cache, second level cache, physical memory or the RAM, we have the virtual memory on the hard disk, right? HDD, or you can say SSD, right? So this is the memory hierarchy, and you can see, you know, the usual amount of typical size of this hierarchy. And I think I don't need to discuss much on this, because at the beginning I had already told you, in the other subject you have already studied all these things in operating system and all, right? In very detail of this. So in memory hierarchy, I'm not discussing much. Okay. Then locality in program. The conventional wisdom is that program spends 90% of their time executing 10% of the code. So programs often contain many instructions that are never executed. So only a small fraction of the code that could be invoked is actually executed in a typical run of the program. So the typical program spends most of its time executing innermost loop and tight recursive cycles in the program. So here is, you know, part of heap, how it looks like, you can see. Then comes the garbage collection, which is very important to know for all the computer science engineers. There is three main methods of doing garbage collection. One is called reference counting, another is called mark and shuf, and short pause method. Okay. So the essence is that programming is easier if the runtime system, the garbage collects. Then the runtime system itself collects the garbage. Okay. Make space belonging to unusable data available for reuse. Like the Java does it, but C does not do the garbage collection during the runtime. Okay. But stack allocation in C gets some of the advantages. Now, speed. Low overhead for garbage collection, right? It is one of the thing. Then little program interruption, that is many collectors shut down the program to hunt for the garbage, you know, the used memory spaces, right? So that is something, interruption happens in the normal execution of the program. And locality, that is data that is used together in place, is placed together on pages, okay, and catch lines. The model is like there is a root set of data that is a priori reachable. For example, in Java, root set equal to static class variables plus variables on runtime stack. Then reachable data, root set plus anything referenced by something reachable. Okay, then then model two, you can see here that things, requiring space are object, available space is in a heap, is the large area managed by the runtime system. Then there is allocator, find space for new object. Okay, space for an object is shown as chunk in the diagrams, and this term chunk is used. Okay, so usually, you know, when during programming or discussion, when you say a memory chunk, what does it mean? It means it is a amount of memory where one object can be stored. Okay. Then garbage collector finds unusable objects. These objects are not usable anymore and returns their space to the heap. Okay. And maybe move object around the around in the heap. You know, it moves object around in the heap to, you know, keep all the free spaces together in one side. Okay. like you can see here. It is quite fragmented. Free spaces are there in a heap, you can see. So here some free spaces is there. Here some free space. Here you have some free space. Here we have some free space. So how the garbage collector working here? It is having the free list here, like a, you know, linked list. Then this is pointing to the next available free space. Then that is again pointing to the next available free space. So that if you know, a higher amount of data, large amount of data comes, then it can use all these free spaces together to store the, you know, bigger object. So taxonomy, you can see garbage collector, there is reference counters and trace based counter. Okay, so reference counting is the simplest but imperfect method to give each object a reference count. Okay, number of references to this object, that means how many so there is object in the memory, is memory, some object is stored here. Okay, now say main function is you know, using it, so there will be one reference. Then say other functions, a quick short is going to read it, there will be another reference. So reference count will be one, here it will become two, and then if there is another one, say some x function, say it will be reference count will be three. Now, when this function will be terminated, it is not going to read anymore, then this 3 will be decreased to 2. So, like this. So, if object have no internal reference, initially object have one reference. If reference count becomes 0, object is garbage. Let me see. If you know, this quick shot is also not reading this object, main is also not reading this object, that reference count will be 0 for this object. So when it is 0, your system will understand that this object is not holding or holded by any process anymore. So it will be comes under garbage collection. So this object will be treated as garbage and its space becomes available. Example, so integer I equal to new integer 10. So integer object is created with RC1. So j equal to k, j, k are integer references. So object reference by j has rc minus minus, and the reference counter minus minus, object referenced by k has reference counter plus plus. So in this way it can happen. Then transitive effects, if an object receives reference counter equal 0 and is collected, the references within the object, you know, within the object disappear, right? So follow these references and decrement the reference counter in the object list. That may result in more object with the reference counter 0, leading to recursive collection. Okay, so like this, you can see here, this is root object, right? These are different objects, you know, pointing to each other. Okay, so, and in bracket, these are the, you know, reference counter. Now you can see this A0 is not pointed by any of the other object. So reference counter became 0 for A0. So A0 is removed, right? It is treated as garbage. Then as soon as A0 removed, this will also going to be removed. This is also going to be removed, right? If A0 is not there, then how A0 can refer to these objects? Understand? So this has happened here. So immediately the reference counter of C becomes zero. Okay. So and so on, it is happening. Okay. Now B, D, E are, you know, garbage, but their reference counts all are greater than zero and they never get collected. So these are the different problem, you know, in garbage collection using reference counting. Understand? So there is a huge taxonomy of garbage collection. I'm not going to do everything, right? Marking, shaping. Okay, then Baker's method will come, Baker's algorithm. Okay. And then the basic mark and compact, the basic method is there. Okay, so what is compact and all? Then, you know, in the mark and compact, there is another method called Chinese method. So that is another way, another thing, another way of doing garbage collection. Then in short pause, interest based, you know, short pause, there is incremental garbage collection. Okay, so I'm not going into detail of all these things. Then partial garbage collection is there. In under partial, there is generational garbage collection. Okay. And after generational, there is train garbage collection is another method. Okay. So there is, you know, many methods of garbage collection. I'm not going into the detail. Okay. You can go later in the detail because we don't have enough time. And, you know, they are very simple thing. You can understand by reading them. Okay. So panic mode is the final one. The problem is that it is possible that when collecting the first car, nothing is garbage. So we then have to create a new car of the first train that is essentially the same as the old first car. Okay. Then if that happens, we go into panic mode, which requires that if reference to any object in the first train is rewritten, we make the new reference a dummy member of the root set. During this garbage collections, you see, okay, if we encounter a reference from the root set, we move the reference object to another train. Then, subtle point, if references to the first train never mutate, eventually, all reachable object will be sucked out of the first train, leaving the cyclic garbage. But previously, the least reference to the first train object could move around, so it is never to the first car. Okay, so this I don't know. I'm just ending this discussion here.